Dear students, we have discussed about hashing and we have discussed in detail that what are hash files and how hashing function is calculated. Today we will be discussing the practical real examples that how hashing works. So what is a hash function? So we have discussed that in hashing files, the most important thing is the hash function. How we can calculate a function that will tell us that this record will or should go into that particular bucket or not. So for example, if we have 10 buckets, so record number 6 is coming, so that record number 6 will be going into which of the bucket available to us. That kind of thing is called hash function, and that hash function need to be invented. So there are different ways to find or to implement the hash function. One of the simplest method is remainder method. So let's have an example. So we should try to remember our previous discussion on remainder operator, which we discussed in the programming modules. So do you remember that what would be the remainder if we, for example, divide 12 with 10? So 10 ones are 10. And this 2 is the remainder. And if, for example, we divide 22 with 10, so 10 twos are 20, and we will be left with 2. And interestingly, if we divide 2 with 10, so 10, 0 or 0, and we will be left with the remainder 2. So this could be one of the methods to calculate that which bucket this record should go. So for example, the record number 12, the record number 22, the record number 2, all should go into the bucket number 2, which is over here. So this means we have here, for example, multiple buckets. So for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 buckets. So 1 bucket, 2 bucket, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bucket and 10th bucket. So the record number 12, 22 and 2 all will be stored in the second bucket. So this will be stored in second bucket. This will be stored in second bucket. And this 2 will be stored in second bucket. So this means whatever the number comes, we will take remainder with 10. And whatever left, we will store that remainder will tell us that in which bucket that number should be stored. So for example, if the number is, or the record is, for example, 99, so we will divide 99 on 10, so 10 nines are 90, we will left with 9 as remainder. This means the number 99 will be stored at bucket number 9 as the remainder is 9. So this is one of the simplest way that we divide any number, whatever we want to store, by some number which is agreed upon at the first location, and then we want to store that thing into that particular bucket. And how we select that particular number by which we want to take the remainder, we normally try to identify such a pattern that can lead to such a record that the records are dispersed. It should not happen that all of the records are saved into one particular location. So whatever records are coming into our data, so those should be stored in all of the buckets which we have made. So this means we will see the data. So if data has majority of numbers having 2 at the unit place. So this means all of those numbers will be stored at bucket number 2 and all of these buckets will remain empty. So this means that we need to change our hashing function that whatever number comes, so those should be covered in all of these 10 buckets. It should not be aggregated at one place. So let's suppose we have a key value of employee. So normally employees don't have value of 1, 2, 3, 4. So the key value or the employee code or employee identification number is 25X3Z. So one of the method to reach to that bucket number is that we take this number and we find the ASCII of this number. So the ASCII of, for example, character 2, then 5, then X, then 3, then Z. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 numbers. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So until here, this is basically the storage of 2. And then next 8 are storage of 5. Next 8 for X, 3Z. So these are 40 numbers. And you know that 0 has an ASCII value of 48. 1 have 49 and 2 has 50. So this means we have formed the ASCII value of 50 over here to translate 2 into this bit pattern. And remember that when we want to store 50 in the bit pattern, we say 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 32 plus 16 is 48, and then plus 2 is 50. So this is one of the module in which we have explained all of these things in the start of the course. So when you have formed the ASCII representation, then we convert it into base 10 equivalent value. And then we divide by a remainder. So in this example, we have taken the remainder of 41. And we are supposing that we have buckets of 40 buckets ranging from 0 to 40. So this value has given us 3. And this 3 is the bucket number where it should be stored. So there is another concept known as clustering. So the records being stored should be distributed evenly among the buckets, and this is the goal of the hashing, as we have discussed. And what does clustering means? That this proportionate number of keys happen to hash to the same bucket. So this means majority or most of the records are coming at one particular bucket, as we have seen that if all of the remainders are 2, so then second number bucket will be overloaded and all other buckets will be empty. So such a concept is known as clustering. So for example, you can see again over here that the number was 55, 96 and 14. And when we divide it with 41, 41, 41, so we take the remainder of 14. So all of these numbers will be stored at cluster at bucket number 14. And if there are more such numbers, so this means that this 14 number bucket will be overly crowded. So the proportion will not be perfect. So we need to use the goal of the hashing by making a hash function that distribute the records into evenly into all of the buckets. So let's summarize today's module. We have learned a practical example of hashing and how hashing works. And we have learned about remainder operator and different examples, and we have learned about the concept of clustering in hashing.